Brother Hale. Let's receive them by saying amen.
Amen.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I was telling Pastor Hill and everybody that was here on Monday night about a situation on my job. A few months ago, I was blessed to get the job that I got right now as a maintenance supervisor of an apartment community that is new to the city. And the lady that got me the job, I hadn't seen her in about 10 years, and she had just got to thinking about me. She called me one day, and I went down, and, you know, one thing led to another, and I ended up getting the job. I thank God for that job, because that job has really opened up a lot of doors for me, and it's been a blessing. And we're all intercessors. That's what I believe. I believe that when we pray for one another, that's what we're doing. We're intercessing for someone. But the lady that got me the job, I've been knowing her for about 20 years, and they decided to terminate her. And they were going to terminate her due to the fact that she was 58 years old. She had a little gray hair. She wasn't as attractive as she used to be when she was young. And her boss told us, you know, things are just not going to work out. You know, you can't run up and down the stairs. You can't lease the apartments like you used to. And we want to bring in someone that can do it. So what they did was they told her, we'll give you about a month, you know, and but we're going to bring in somebody new. So they brought in this little young girl, and that's what she is to me, a little young girl, and she got the real pretty blue eyes, and I guess she's supposed to have a real nice looking body and everything like this, and all the men down on the job, they were just drooling. Did you see so-and-so and so? You see what they brought in? Man, we're going to really get some, you know, good leases and stuff. But to me, that doesn't, you know, that just don't cut it. And what you have done is you have taken away from someone something that they truly need. But what happened was I really felt that she went out of her way to give me the job that I have. So I went to her, do you ever think about praying? And what she said to me was, she said, Ola Al, she said, I know you're a man of God and, you know, everything like that, but she said, you know, prayer only works for some folks. And so I said, well, Kathy, I said, you know, let's just touch and agree that this thing will turn around. And so she and I, we went secret place on the job, and we held hands and we prayed. And I'm one that believes that when you pray, and if you ask God for certain things, He's going to make that thing come around. So a couple of days later, her boss contacted her and said, you know, I think I might have made a mistake. We're going to, you know, let you continue to work. But, you know, there was some kind of clauses and different things of that nature. But at the same time, what I thought about was prayer works.
Yeah.
If it wasn't for praying with her, I don't think she would have got that job, her job back. But I also think that that helped her build up her faith. But I really believe that if you're earnestly seeking God and doing the right things, and if you get with someone or just get by yourself, and truly ask the Lord, Father, just bless me. Bless me with this home. Bless me with this job. Bless me with whatever. I truly believe God answers prayers. So her prayer was answered. And I thank God for that. But on Thursday, she decided that she didn't want to keep the job. Well, she said, well, now, she said, if they do it to me once, they may do it to me again.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I told her, I said, Kathy, I said, what I want you to do is just continue to seek the Lord. Because if you seek Him, you know, like He said, He'll find you. And so I just want you all to continue to pray for her. Continue to pray for her faith. She has to increase her faith. And that's something that a lot of us have to do. We have to build on our faith. I thank God that when I came here to Northside, I get a chance to pray. I get a chance to pray with my brothers and sisters. I think one thing that has helped me is I'm diligent in prayer. I come here on Monday evenings. I come here Wednesdays. Come sometime on Tuesday mornings. I have a job. I have a family. I have a responsibility. But I'm committed to God. I'm committed to my school. I go to school here, Harvest Time Prayer Ministry, which I think has really blessed me. It's really helped me. And we can go to Rhema, we can go to Victory, ORU, and I'm going to Harvest Time. And I have grown. I've seen my wife grow. I've seen our family grow. And so I'm just asking you all, just continue to pray for one another and think about coming out on those nights of Monday evening. We have a good time in the Lord. We really do. And we have fun. So thank you for listening to me. God bless.
Your job, you said that's not about your job. Your job is secure.
Oh, my job is secure. matter of fact, I'm the supervisor, and they have a guy down there who's over me. But he's kind of got some of them. They sent me Friday to pick up some supplies. And when I went to pick up those supplies, he was thinking, well, you know, this guy, you know, he don't know what he's doing. And, you know, this, I'm going to pick up some paint at Sherwin-Williams. So I didn't take no paint cans. I didn't take anything with me. I've done it. You know, this is a rodeo. I've been to all sorts of rodeos. So I done rode this horse. So I go out there and I come back, you know, a lot quicker than what he has done. And he goes out there with me, and we get out there. When we walked inside Sherwin-Williams, these people hadn't seen me in years, the people that run the place. And they say, hey, Al, you back? And I say, oh, yeah, you know, blah, blah. And I told him I'm working with this new company and stuff. And so as I was getting ready to pay them, they looked at me and they said, well, why don't we just open up an account for the job? You know, like that. So the guy said, that was with me, he said, oh, we can't do that, you know. He don't have that type of authority, you know, like that. And the guy at the place said, well, Al Jackson doesn't need that type of authority from us. We're just going to give this to him. So when I went back to the job, my boss looked at me and said, you know, Al, we might have to send you out to more places. And so it just comes to show you that when you seek God, when you do the things that you know you're supposed to be doing, God's going to reward you. Yeah. So I just thank God for everything that He's done. Amen. Yeah.